Norsemen lived long ago, mostly came from countries that are a part of Scandinavia. Most people at that time had a constant struggle against cold and against hunger and disease. Because they were so poor, many Norsemen sailed away. These were the Vikings. The Vikings had several gods, the chief of whom was Odin. Odin lived in Asgard, the home of the Norse gods. As well as being god of war and death, he was also the god of magic and wisdom. Like most of the gods, he didn't reside in Asgard all the time. Sometimes he wandered down to Midgard. Odin sometimes rode his magical horse named Sleipnir, which had 8 legs and was terribly fast. All the same, Odin got tired of walking and riding about. One day, when he was really fed up with wandering, he had a good idea. "If only I could see everything that is going on," he said to himself, "then I could stay at home." And he thought about it for a while. What he needed was true wisdom. If only he had true wisdom, he would be able to stay at home and see everything going on all at the same time. But to gain true wisdom, he knew he would have to drink from the well guarded by Mimir, the wisest guy in Midgard. The next morning, Odin left Asgard. He took his favorite knapsack and set off for Mimir's well. The journey was dangerous, for he had to climb over rocky mountains, face blizzards, snow, ice. The well was near the giants that lived in Jotunheim, very dangerous place, not very hospitable. "He won't give me a drink for nothing," said Odin. "The price will be very high." How right Odin was. As Odin tramped along the road to the well, he met a giant riding on the back of a reindeer. He immediately recognized this lofty fellow. He was the wisest of the giants, who knew many things. But for all wisdom, he did not see through Odin's disguise. Odin had pulled himself up to the height of the giant and fell into conversation with him. "There's something I would dearly like to learn from you," he said. And the giant replied jovially, "Ho, ho! Before you can learn from me, you must answer 3 riddles. And if you answer them wrong, you will lose your head. But if you answer them right, you can ask me a question in return." This was not the sort of game that Odin liked, but he consented to the terms. "Well," said the giant, "these are the questions. What is the name of the river that divides Asgard from Jotunheim? What is the name of the horses that day and night drive across the sky? And what is the name of the plain on which the last battle will be fought?" Odin breathed a sigh of relief, because he knew the answers. He knew them well. "Ifling is the deadly cold river that freezes in an instant any living that falls into it. Skinfax and Hjarmfax are the horses that drive day and night across the sky. The field for the last battle is Vigard. That's where you and I are destined to fight in the end of days." "Hmm," said the giant, "you keep your head." The giant was disappointed, because he liked taking people's heads and cooking them for dinner. "Now it's your turn." "Well," said Odin, "just tell me what I'll have to give Mimir from a drink of the Well of Wisdom." "He will ask for your right eye," said the giant. Odin shuddered. "That's a lot to ask for. Is there no other way?" "There is no other way. Many have asked for the Wind of Wisdom of the Waters, but none have yet agreed to pay the price." Odin nodded. He was glad to leave the wise but fierce giant. Depressing when Odin thought about the eye he would have to lose forever. Odin continued his journey, eventually reaching Giant's Land, where Mimir stood by his well. "Ho there, Odin, I've been waiting for you," said Mimir. "Do you wish to drink from my well?" "Yes," said Odin, "I have a great thirst for wisdom, and yes, I need to drink from your well." Mimir laughed. "No one has yet agreed to pay my price. You must give me your right eye." Odin considered one last time if the price was too high. His pale blue eyes were the color of the sky, and his eye could spot a bird from a giant distance. But he did have 2 of them. "I will pay your price, Mimir." And so saying, he tore his right eye from his head. The pain was searing. He gave it to the guardian of the well. Mimir handed him a horn brimming with the waters of wisdom. Odin took a deep drink. Immediately he saw everything that had happened and everything that was in the future. Seeing all the sorrows and troubles that would happen to mankind, he knew what he could do to help. After he drank from the Well of Wisdom, he knew that he must never let evil get the upper hand of humans, and that he would always stand by his mankind. And that is the story how Odin got his true wisdom and how he lost his eye.
Didn't go far.